think it's for you marine crazy motherfucker. Ah! And then when they see a big fat nigga coming out there working out, bringing out his intercept, so you see what I'm saying?
Game changer.
Of course. I ain't know much about it, but whatever they know, they just afraid of it. I tell them, you could do it. Shit gonna train you. It's gonna get your mind right. Y'all could use some of this if y'all want to. All you gotta do is put some of my music in the background.
That's so nice.
I got a feeling, nigga, when it see it. Money be the roof. Look up at the stars, she like honey with a roof. It's CrossFit. See the RossFit. It's official. Just always remember, when you hear CrossFit, that is RossFit. When you hear me screaming RossFit, I'm screaming CrossFit, you hear me? It's the family, it's the movement, that's what I'm on, that's what we rocking with. We getting better, we getting healthy, we getting paper. Y'all see we winning. You ain't know we was winning? Check the scoreboard. Yeah, thought so.
When you first work with someone, you have to figure out what their taste profile is. That's number one. And then you have to kind of like, once you figure that out, then you know how to kind of mask certain things. Like, he wasn't keen on the raw kale. And I would sneak the kale in omelets and different things, and now he just loves it.
I'm finna release my 7th album.
There you go.
I'm releasing my debut in 06, Port of Miami. And, you know, I've just been trying to be consistent. As long as I love what I'm doing, I feel like I'm gonna be, you know, if not the best, one of the best at it.
Is it hard to let go of the album once you're done? Like, tweak it a little more.
You know, you always go find shit to do with your music. You know what I'm saying? You always, as you sitting there, you know, and you somebody who always thinking of something, you know, at all times. I always go find something else to say or do. But, you know, I think the cool point is, you know, once I get to it and, you know, I feel it's done, you know, it's done. Any new ideas, you know, we'll maybe save them for the next album. Welcome to the home of the brave.
Maybach music.
Rosé. Huh. I'm so self-made. I can still count a meal without a money machine, nigga.
The sexy voice, the woman who says Maybach music in all the songs. Whose idea was that? And is that the same woman in all of them? And who is she?
What is this? Maybach music.
I like this Maybach music. Sweet.
You know, she is a beautiful person. You know, hello, what's up? It is the same chick, you know what I'm saying? And we was in the studio one night. And shout out to the big homie Jay-Z. The first time we actually used that was on the front of Maybach Music 1, a record that I did with Jay-Z. And, you know, when he heard it, he was like, so we ran with it, you know?
It's good. It's like, it burned into my brain. I just hear it now. Like, I know.
And, you know, once you see her, she most definitely will do the same, too. I guess it ain't no nice way to tell you niggas it's game over, huh?
The best places. Don't get this one. It just looks bad.
Maybach music.
Do you write his name on the bag?
Yeah.
What do you write? Do you write the boss?
That's exactly what I write. I said, boss food, don't touch. I put the boss food.
And how do you spell that?
Boss, yeah. B-O-Z-Z.
You do? Everyone spells it different.
Or B-O-W, he likes it, B-A-W-S-E, balls.
Balls.
B-A-W-S-E, balls.
Balls. Your first tattoo that you got on your face, which one is it?
Will?
No, he said on my face.
On your face, oh.
I don't remember which one.
Was that a hard boundary to cross?
Not at all. Not at all.
Just another spot.
Yeah, for me. Most definitely for me. Look into my eyes. Shout out to everybody that's working out now. Everybody that's on their CrossFit, AKA RossFit. You know what I'm talking about? Keep going. We just starting up. You know what I'm talking about? Bel Air, baby.
Albums that come out so quick, back-to-back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not too many guys before
that
shit. Yeah. The last one I did, it was DMX.
DMX did
that? Yeah, two number one albums, and that's what I'm coming, you know. Not just two albums in 1 year, but two number ones.
How long were you rapping before you were comfortable saying you were a rapper?
Pretty sure it was a few years. You know, my mom used to play her vinyl records, and it was one of my mom's records. You know, don't laugh at me, but it was a record called Centipede by Reebok Jackson. You know, that was just one of the records that I really, you know, developed a flow or a pattern to.
Did you rap in the closet before you let anyone hear you? Like, would you just be in the bedroom, door closed, just rapping away?
Yeah, nah, it was really me and my homeboys. You know, because, you know, once we start seeing album covers, and once I would see a Run DMC album cover, I was like, wow, I see the vision, you know what I'm saying? And just the power of the music.
You said in one of the songs, right? You say you walked 40 minutes to get your first Two Life crew tape.
Yeah. Yeah, I was a youngster, and that was the flea market. That's where we were going by cassettes, our vinyl tapes, and that's where I bought everything as a youngster from. And I remember just going in, and I wanted the Two Live Crew record, and, you know, I bought that. And I looked at, I seen other dudes' vinyls. I saw a dude named King T from the West Coast, and I just saw his orange 64 Impala. And I seen his seats was orange and white with the pinstripes, and I said, damn, I want that car. Not only that, can I buy this album? You know what I mean? And I bought the album just based on the cover, and it's about getting in power, putting your people on, you know what I'm saying, the team, you know what I'm saying, chasing your dreams. You got to go hard, okay? But, and everybody doing it, okay? I see what it is. It's just like being in a CrossFit box. Everybody trying to get that top max out, you heard me? And that was the whole game, and you know, just that competitiveness, you know, that's what bring out the most talent.
And run the business.
I don't email. I don't know how to email. I never email. So if you ever emailed me, you thought you was emailing me, you never emailed me, stop. You fooled yourself. I've never got an email. I don't get emails. I've never.
Maybach shit.
Bright lights and dark corners. It's night and bark on us. Refugees running wild. White cleft for the sick Sawyer. Huh. Nothing to lose. I was starving from the start.
Me.
Not the same cat driving Jaguars. Open fire when you see me. Yeah, a lot of men can whisper. The club that I'm a member, they'll be gone by November.
I get up, check in, make a few calls. My signals, that rosé, start coming from everywhere, no matter what city you in or what block you on, you heard me? Double MG, we here. Believe that.
How has working out affected your inner dialogue?
You know, it's just, you know, being in better shape, it affects everything. Of course, your health, of course, your psyche, your confidence. You know, me traveling a lot, you know, that's one of the things that, you know, where I feel it the most. you know, me being a big dude, on planes, off planes, boarding planes. I believe me getting in better shape, me losing, you know, that extra weight I needed to lose. I think that just, you know, that's one of the areas that never gets the attention it needs to. But, you know, me getting around a lot better, man, I feel a lot better. Miami, the Playboy's paradise. Pretty girls, fast cars. That's just a facade. The bridge separates South Beach from my Miami. The real Miami. The MIA. This is where we hustle.
Every day I'm hustling. Every day I'm hustling. Every day I'm hustling. Every day I'm hustling.
It's on your early album. If I understand them correctly, you're basically saying part of your drive is a pursuit of giving back and sort of asking for forgiveness for some things that you don't go into specifics, but things that you've done in your past that you want to make up for.
Right.
And so it's basically like managing some inner discomfort. And I've heard like other, you know, great prolific artists talk about that. As you get money and you can manage that discomfort with money, is it taking away from your art? Do you feel like you can manage that pain that drives your creativity with money and then...
I feel
corrupt yourself.
You know, for me, I feel it's best to keep, you know, your passion and your art completely separate from anything financial.
Every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling, every day I'm hustling. Who you suckers think you're tripping with? Yes, I'm the boss. 745, white on white, that's Rick Ross. I keep them wide, I keep them long, I keep them fat. I keep them coming back, we keep them coming back.
You know, because before I had any financial gain, I was 15 years in and I had done told myself, yo, if I never made it, if I never got a record deal, I was going to be content with who I was. And, you know, I wouldn't regret doing nothing, you know what I mean?
I mean, that's got to be a constant battle, right?
I mean,
for anyone, if I get a 55-inch TV, I want to go home and watch it rather than go out in the gym and work out, right?
You might have to hang it in the gym.
Right.
YMCMB.
As I look around, we the only niggas with that A1 Perico. I'm smoking dope, I'm on my cell phone. I'm selling dope, straight off the iPhone. He want a quote, he talking 9 zones. He bought four, I front him 5 more.
What do you think of Instagram? You like that medium?
I love it.
Do you approve all the pictures before they go up?
The ones, I post my own pictures.
Oh, you do?
Yeah. I post my own pictures. So when we taking pictures out here, we tweeting, whatever we doing, you know, I post my own pictures. So if Ricky Rose posted it, it's official. So go and repost them, you hear me?
What phone do you use?
iPhone. Yeah.
You happy with it?
Nah, I was just in the house.
No, I said, are you happy with it?
Yeah, it's cool. I'd be much happier once they give me that money back, you hear me? I'm gonna go real hard then, you know what I'm saying? But most definitely, you know, we get it in. We get the job done.
I asked Garrett, I said, are you the only white dude in the crew? And he tried to tell me he wasn't white.
Nah, he not white.
Oh, he's not?
No.
Tan.
That's what he said. He said, I'm tan.
Yeah, you tan. You understand? But, you know, this is my homie. And if he was white, he's still my homie. You understand? And a lot of times, Garrett is pretty much working out the fucking half of the fucking federal system back here. But yeah, so, you know, we be back here, we work out, and that's the beauty of it, man. It's people from different walks of life, but we all have the same thing, the same common goal. Just want to enjoy your life, you know, and compete at the highest level. And that's what CrossFit is.
Is there a, trying to remember the exact words you use in the song, your boss lady? What did you call her? The lead boss lady. Is there a lead boss lady? The one that... I read that line to you that I wrote down.
The lead boss lady?
Yeah, do you have a lead boss lady? Is there one?
Nah.
There isn't?
Nah.
And that's the lady that asks for head first? She gets head first.
Boss lady, she the head bitch in charge. She asks for head first, so she gets it off the top.
Oh, she can't get no head first. No.
But it's in your song.
Yeah. Sometimes, you know, sometimes we got to entertain them, you know what I mean? We got to entertain the ladies with this here's RossFit. This is a high performance ladies, you know what I mean? So, you know.
Rolling them L's up. Get money.
This is the life, this is the life. Ain't no stopping the champagne from popping. This is the life, this is the life.
Let's take it to the next level. Let's push each other. That's why I wanted to, you know, get into CrossFit. I'm a chicken wing lover, avid smoke, one of the best smokers, well known everywhere from LA, Colorado. The best dispensaries got my face on the wall. But guess what? You know, CrossFit is for people like me as well. You know, people who just want to not play no games. You want to work out? Let's go. That's what this about. You want to go over there and do jumping jacks with the cheerleaders? That's cool, too. We wave at you when we ride by, but if you really want to get it in, you got 20 minutes in a day. Like I do, I ain't got a lot of time to do all that other stuff. I got 20, 30 minutes. So we come out here, we get it in, we feel good, go in, get something, you know, good to eat. And, you know, the day starts like a boss.
Enjoying the training with Garrett?
I love it, man. I love it. You know, for the first time, you know, I'm on, you know, getting it in, working out. And it's just really, it's that's the thing about that CrossFit. That shit's so dominating that it just reroutes your whole way of moving. You know what I'm saying? And that's what makes it as far as me. I believe, you know, I don't want to use the term easy, but fuck it, let's use it. Easy for me to, you know, lose 75 pounds and not feel like I'm struggling every day.
Yeah.
Because you can still eat, you know what I'm saying? Nigga, eat heavier in the morning, heavy during the day, and just chill out during the, you know what I'm talking about? As you go on later on, you know what I'm saying? And then when you get your 3-4 days of workout in.
Alright, Ross, let's go for a light jog. Let's go to the second mailbox, come back.
Alright. Good plug on. When you were doing the regionals this year,
were you training Rick Ross? I was. I actually just started the project, so I had to actually not come here for a week.
Were you concerned that if you were tested at the performance-enhancing drugs that Rick Ross takes?
He doesn't take anything. It's just hard work, man. Just hard work.
His marijuana habit. Weren't you afraid that maybe you could?
I wasn't really too worried about it. Yeah.
Some secondhand smoke, positive testing.
I mean, I'm around it for sure, but I wasn't really too worried about it, and it didn't happen anyway. I didn't qualify, so
the testing didn't happen. Real quick, like before we first started, like Ross was having trouble, like just to run through that first mailbox, and now he's able to do multiple last mailbox and back. So that's just a little progress he's made so far. He's doing great.
Rick, did you play sports in high school?
Yeah, played football, center, made all city.
Ricky Ross, T-Pain. About to have a parking lot on smash. Plus I got a 7 with a 454 in the hood. That bitch got 125 on the dash.
I'm the biggest boss that you seen thus far. I'm the biggest boss that you seen thus far.
Right. Put the high pull in there, so dip shrug high pull. Right here, high and outside elbows, and go.
I don't make love, baby, we make magic. Come home with a thug, let's get shit cracking. Always well plastic, baby, cause shit happens. She leave the back seat just to freak in the Magnum. Hopped out the Magnum, hopped in the tray just to let the top back and thank God for the day. Who gives a fuck what a hater gotta say? I made a couple $1 million.
Wanna try 155?
Still in the streets. With them things, she in love with the G, so she said it. My name.
3, 2, 1, and go. 5 and 10.
I'ma make it ring, then I'ma make it back. You are just a lame, you a homie, that's a fact. Working with the police,
boy, I like it.
Fresh out of jail, already in your OG.
come on, finish up, finish up. We're almost there. Almost there.
Smash. Plus, I got a 7 with a 4 with the flow in the hood. This got 125 on the dash.
I'm the biggest boss that you seen thus far. I'm the biggest boss that you seen thus far.
Four more. Here you go, last four. Let's go. Three more. Good. Come on, two more. You don't need a break. Two more.
I'm the biggest boss that you've seen thus far. Got the biggest car, Spanish bras, no bra. Call it other lane for the walks in the parks. Ain't come to play.
That fires me up. Stuff like that fires me up. Yeah, every day when we work out, he definitely pushes his limits, and it's cool, and it shows too. It's cool. I enjoy it. It's stuff like that really fires me up.
You know, this at the beginning when we first was working out, and Garrett was showing us all the, you know, the workouts we was finna do for the day, and we was finna go heavy, and you know, showing us how he wanted to see us, you know, execute, you know, the exercises. And we got into it, and in the middle of one of the exercises, Gary made a comment, and then one of the dudes that was working out with us said, "Hold on, man. How much you deadlift, though?" Yo, end of story. Shout out to Gary Fisher, you heard me? You heard me? Salute to the big homie.
What did you answer with?
I recently did a triple at 535. Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, it was a good triple too. So that was recent.
What'd it be on your mind?
That it's just because it's the weight's so heavy that all it takes is just a little deviation. Misstep, little deviation, and then your back is messed up for a month or two, and then training just stops completely. Yeah, that's the issue.
Heavy weights scare you, man.
Scare me.
If you was doing, how much you think you would put on the rack?
Hopefully over 600.
Yeah, sounds
over,
like you did.
Over 600. If I did 535 for a triple, I should be able to get 600 for one.
I'll say high fives.
High fives for sure.
Don't let
Dave
fucking high fives. 600 is good. I like
that you're there. High fives. I'll be
go
pushing.
Back to six. Say six. Just
high fives. Yeah.
That's crazy.
You see? So a lot of people. I hear people. They say, "Rose, boy, you lost weight." They say you cut yourself. Idle thinking, baby. Jeez.
That's the boss thing?
Oh, this is the boss punch. Blueberries, peaches, pears, on a light lemonade. So really it's lemonade with no sugar. And you put the fruit in it to add the, you see? You see?
I see it.
See the G right here. And you know when the boss says the G, you better know it.
There's no finales around here, baby. No finales.
Am I clear to you?